Hey, this is Mike. I'm here at Grand Strand Nissan in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and I'm checking out a 2015 Nissan Pathfinder. And this is the Platinum trim level in pearl white. And if you're looking for a 7-passenger vehicle, definitely want to consider this one. This one in particular is the 4-wheel drive, and it also has a towing package with a 5,000-pound towing capacity. So it's definitely a good travel vehicle for the whole family, and so I think it's amazing. But you know, if you have any experience with one of these, let me know. Going on a trip with it or anything like that, I'm impressed with it. But so let's go ahead and check it out. Here in the front, we've got no projector headlights on this one, and I'm not sure if they're halogens or what kind of headlights these are. I'm kind of surprised it doesn't show on the window sticker, but it does have the fog lights as well. Kind of close up there, maybe somebody knows about the technology on the headlights. But here's the front, and this one, this vehicle is more of a, it doesn't have a real aggressive look like the Murano or the Rogue. This is kind of a traditional look, I guess, SUV. It doesn't have a huge stance off the ground. It has a fairly decent stance, really easy to get in and out of stance. At least that's what I call it. It does have the 20-inch aluminum wheels. Bridgestone tires this one has, and the four-wheel disc brakes. It's got the privacy glass. This one has the dual pane sunroofs there with a luggage rack. So let me go ahead and get the key out. This one does have the remote start here, so I'm going to go ahead and start it up. So I'm going to push, make sure it's locked. I push the lock button and push and hold the startup button there. So now that it's started, I'm going to go ahead and unlock it with the key. I can just walk up and with the key in my pocket. This is an intelligent key. The car senses the key when it's nearby. So I could just literally push that button to unlock the door. But I'm going to go ahead and unlock the entire car by go ahead and pushing the unlock button here on the remote twice. And I'm going to put the key back in my pocket. So here's the window sticker before I go too much further, in case you want to use the pause button and check it out. So here's the inside of the front passenger side, shotgun as people call it. You want to ride shotgun? Here you go. Now this one has the tan interior. It does have a little bit of wood grain accents there. And some very soft, everything in here is soft, it feels like, even up here. But it has tons of room here in the front. It does have a power seat. This side doesn't have any lumbar support, the driver's side does. You have the carpeted mats here that say Pathfinder on them. You got a storage pocket there on the left side. Left knee area. Now the glove compartment is pretty interesting. It's compartmentalized where you have like a little shelf system in there. Goes in there a mile, it looks like. So but definitely would be a little bit of an idea to keep stuff right here where that you need to access, and then because really digging back there, that looks like it can get really cluttered, and and also it goes down and kind of gets in the way of the knees, it looks like, a little bit for the person riding shotgun there. So I guess it'll just go down and rest on their knees, and they can dig through there trying to find what they want. It does have the illuminated Pathfinder. This is a protective film here. So this comes off, and this is illuminated. Hopefully I'll be able to do some at-night videos on these fairly soon, so you can get an idea of what they look like at night. Alright, so here's the interesting stuff. Here is where all the rest of the people are going to sit, besides the driver and passenger there in the front. You got more passenger room here in the back. You got a bottle holder here on the door. Everything's high quality, just as the front. And this one has the DVDs in DVD screens there in the headrests. So you have those two for the second row, and I guess the third row can look over their shoulders and watch it too, but that's there. Now this seat right here, you can see these seats slide forward and back. This one's all the way forward, that one's all the way back. So that way you can get an idea of the different adjustability on these seats. Another thing that's pretty cool here is these are reclining. Let's see if I can do it with one hand. There. They will recline, as well as the third row seat. So the second and third and first, all the seats in this vehicle will recline. So you can kind of get that just right seating position, especially on long trips. So you can adjust, you know, for more or less leg room here in the front. It does fold flat too. But, and also, now, because the back, a little bit limited on the leg room there. You know, for one thing, the floorboard is kind of shallow compared to the seat. So if you have a little bit of long legs or something, your knees are going to be in the air. So basically, the third row seems to be more for like children and stuff. So let's go ahead and put this seat all the way back so you can see that there's plenty of leg room here in the front. You know, the floorboard is a little bit shallow, so compared to the seat. So you know, if you got long legs, your knees will be a little bit high up. All right, so this does have a center console that armrest here with some cup holders and little pocket there. And here's your controls for your climate control for the rear passengers, as well as some heated seats back here. The front are heated and cooled, the back are just heated. So you've got, you also have little volume buttons here, so you can adjust the volume. You can plug in headphones here, but it also has a, comes with wireless headphones. So you can either plug them in or, you know, do the wireless thing. So there's your volume switches there going in and out. And you also have these RCA inputs here, the audio and video inputs for, you know, different devices to connect to. And of course this is a AC adapter here, so you can plug in stuff and charge it. Really handy for laptops and all kinds of different things that you need to charge or power. It is only 150 watts, so it's not like it's going to power a, you know, like a hairdryer or anything like that. So you can see this does have the tan leather interior. Got the perforations here in the center and in the back. And like say, if you need to access the third row, it's got this convenient handle here. Lift it up and it kind of sandwiches up the seat like so. And that gives you a little bit of a, you know, step here. So it's got this plastic threshold here so you can step right there and climb in. And the third row does have some cup holders here and pretty good, pretty high headrests. And that bag there is your the remote control and headphones and different accessories. Plenty of leg room, and also you got that panoramic sunroof there, which I'll show you that in a few minutes. Just going to put this back. All right, so now moving on to the back. Here, you've got your, one thing that stands out right away. It doesn't, I mean, it's not ugly or anything, but there's your trailer hitch. It also has the 7-way plug here. And you've got your sonar sensors back here. For backing up, it'll let you know if you get close to something in case you have a, I mean, it does have the around view monitor too, so you got the sonar sensors, you got the around view monitor, backup camera, all that good stuff, so you shouldn't have any problem seeing at low, seeing out back when you're parking or whatever. So you got four-wheel drive, and then you got the platinum badge on this side, Pathfinder, and the Grandstra and Nissan going on there. Alright, so let's say you walk up to it. You can just take out the key. You don't have to use the key to do this. There is a button and it has a little label there showing you where the button is, but I'm gonna go ahead and use the key. And so basically you walk into the vehicle and you just push and hold the button here, and it'll open up the back. And that way you can put your groceries or whatever you want to put back here, cargo air stuff. Now, as you can see, this third row seat does take up quite a bit of room back here. So if you don't have any third row passengers, of course you can fold those down. First of all, you'd have to pull that, which unlocks the headrest and folds it down. And then you've got this thing here, handle, you just kind of push it down. Lifting it up, you just reach over and grab the strap and it'll lift it up. But I'm going to leave it down for a second just so you can get an idea of the cargo space there. Now, you know, of course, you can have a passenger and cargo space. Same thing with the second row. This is a 50-50, that's a 60-40 there. So you have some tie downs here. Got these little things, little hook things that stick out in case you, I guess, for like grocery bags or whatever. I do have them on the back of the seats as well. You get a power supply. Now, they've got four power supplies total in this vehicle, so that's pretty handy. This is the front back, the bracket for the front license plate, if you wanted to use that. So under here is a little bit more cargo area, but it also has, this one has the premium Bose sound system. So this has got a wave, acoustic wave system. You know those Bose wave radios that they advertise on TV and stuff and people talk about? Well, this has a similar system as that, to where it gives you that nice deep sound to the music. And this is one of the secret weapons to that right there. All right, so moving on to close it, I don't have to use the key. I could use the key, but I can also push this button here and they'll close it right down. All right, let me get a little bit of a broader look at it so you can see the contours and everything. What's interesting about this vehicle is that it's a seven passenger, very lots of room and everything, but it just doesn't look like some big cumbersome SUV. I guess part of it is the height. It's not a, you know, really high off the ground or anything like that, but sometimes the really huge SUVs are just kind of ridiculous looking, and so that's why I kind of like the way this looks. It just kind of has a more of a normal SUV look, but all the room as a big one. So anyways, all that's about the same there. And so we do have the heated side mirrors here on the side. And here's the cockpit. Inside the driver's door here, you got the bottle holder just like the other doors. You got the presets, and that'll preset for the seat, the steering wheel, and the side mirrors. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, the radio stations, but I might be wrong about that. Please correct me if I'm wrong. Now, this is your window, you know, automatic window controls here. They're automatic in the front, and then the back ones, you have to hold them. You just push and hold it down or up, and that way it'll go all the way up and down. The door locks are here. This button, when you push that, that locks out all these windows here except for the driver's side. So that, just remember that. If you can't get the windows up and down, you might have that button pushed. This is your side mirror controls. So like, you push it to the left, you can adjust your side mirror. Push it to the right, same thing. Put it in the middle so you don't accidentally adjust your mirrors when you don't want to. This one does have the blind spot monitoring system, and there's a little indicator light right here. When there's a vehicle in your blind spot, it'll illuminate orange. Now, if there's a vehicle in your blind spot and you turn your turn signal on, it'll illuminate red and alert you in the car. So it does have a good way of, you know, kind of letting you know that you know, there's somebody there, so, which is handy. Definitely don't want to get an accident. So here's your driver's seat. It does have the, you know, the power up and down, So like a dentist chair, you can really fine tune it and go forward and back, of course. And this is your back, and this is your lumbar support right here. All right, so before I get into the seat here, there's a whole bunch of buttons down here, and it's kind of an interesting place to put a bunch of buttons. I guess a lot of this stuff is, you know, maybe not used all the time, except for the ones here on the top. We'll start down here. This is a blank button, but this one right here is your basically your blind spot monitoring system there. And over here is your tow mode. See, you can turn this on or off, basically. Your tow mode, you can turn that on and off. Your power supply back there, the 110, 115 volt power supply, you have to turn that off to use it. It's not all the way always on unless that switch is on. All right, so the power door, that you can turn off. Now, if you just want to, you know, manually open that power door in the back, you can turn it off. So like, say if, I'm not sure why, maybe like say if, it could be to say if you have a low ceiling in your garage or something like that and you want to lift it up a certain height. Now you do have the ability to manually adjust that. Basically you lift it up to the height you want, push the button, hold it, it'll remember that height. So, you know, maybe you can fill me in on why you'd want to turn that power door off. So this is the button to actually open up the door. This is your heated steering wheel, and this is your traction control button. You can turn that off. Default is on when you start the vehicle, and you can push that to turn it off. This one does have the adjustable telescoping power tilting joystick thing here for the steering wheel. So let me go ahead and get in here. Now you notice the vehicle is off. That is because it only runs for a certain amount of time and turn off. It's not going to run all day. It's not going to burn all your gas out. Okay, so give you an idea of what it sounds like. How quiet it is. It's letting me know that I have to push the brake, which I will do. Push the brake and then push the start button. That's how you start it when you get in the vehicle. As long as you have the key in your pocket, you never really have to take it out. Unless you want to use some of the buttons there. Alright, so we'll start here with the steering wheel. This is a leather wrap steering wheel, stitching on the inside. And let me see here, get the air conditioner blowing on here. And you can see that it is color matched with the seats. Some cars and vehicles have basically just one color steering wheel, and then they just change the color of the seats or whatever. Nissan, you know, they give you dashboards, they give you doors, they give you the seats, the carpet. If you want tan interior, you get tan interior. There's just not like just changing the color of the seats. So so you got the tan steering wheel, and you can see it's pretty, it has a little bit of give to it, so it's not too doesn't wear your hand out. Now it is very grippy. Some of the leather wrap steering wheels are kind of like too smooth to me. This one feels like you can get a really good grip to it. But okay, so it does have some buttons here. There's no buttons on the back of the steering wheel. It's all here on the front. This is your cruise control. You can set it and you can adjust your speed here. And on the left side here, we've got your, once you pair your phone with the Bluetooth system, you can make and receive calls here with this this button here. This is your voice recognition. You push that and there's a certain amount of commands that you can say, such as tune to a certain station or call a certain person, stuff like that. This right here, source and the arrows, the plus and negative, this is your volume for your radio. Source is like say AM, FM, satellite radio, CD, USB, all those things. You can push that and it kind of cycles through. And up here, these buttons here, let me show you something. Here's the
the gauges, okay? So you got your RPMs there to the left, and then your speedometer there to the right, and gas gauge and all that stuff. And it's showing what gear it is in the middle. But you see that little screen here, right in here, this is basically an information screen. And you can push these buttons here, this one right here specifically, and I'm gonna kind of push that and kind of just cycle through. Like it's right now, it's telling you, you know, what percent the front or rear wheels are engaged, and that might be handy, like say in the automatic section. Now, once I get to a menu here where you can scroll up and down, you can use this button here to scroll through the different options, and you can choose what you want. All right. And I'm going to push the menu button again. And you can see this is like a, you know, visual representation of your vehicle going down the road. And this is where you would get like alerts and stuff for the basically for the like say if you had a vehicle in your blind spot or something like that, or lane departure too. It'll give you lane departure warnings as well. All right. So basically, see, that gives you more information there. And then this is your trip. Tire pressures, they won't show up when you're just idling. You do have to, you know, start driving and it'll show up there. Because when you first start the vehicle and it's just sitting there, they're not going to be accurate, and they don't want you to get inaccurate information. So at any time, you can go back, is the back button here. So anyways, there's the steering wheel. You do have an automatic headlight setting here, and the windshield wiper controls are there. They do have one on the back as well. You can reset your trip with this big button here. Can't overlook that. And then you have your buttons here. These two buttons are for your dimmer switches, so you can have more or less illumination on your gauges. Nice big buttons, easy to find there. All right, so, and this air conditioner blowing the other way here. Okay, so here's the 8-inch touchscreen that Nissan has, and it's pretty cool. Right now, we are in, you know, basically the radio screen, and so I'm gonna just kind of show you. There's some buttons down here, and basically you can navigate your way through the different system here. So so right now I'm gonna just kind of, you know, show you. Now you can push the button here, or you can navigate through this arrow screen right here. So I'm gonna hit back. I'm going to hit back there, or I can hit back down here. So there's a little bit of redundant buttons there. And so let me go ahead and let's go to the map screen. There's lots of buttons down here. I'm just trying to choose which one. Let's hit map so we can see what the map looks like. And right now we have, you know, you can change this to a, like say an angled map. Right now we're, you know, top down looking. Trying to keep the camera steady here, but okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and go back out of that, which, well, it's not gonna let me go back. I just have to change here. So I'm gonna hit route. This will take me to a screen where I can enter in a like a specific address, and I could, you know, change route settings, stuff like that, like say to avoid traffic or something. You can put in a specific destination here, and it's got like a different region there. It's got California now, but you can change that. Now, camera button, I'm going to push that. This is awesome. This is the around view camera that Nissan has. This is basically, right now it's showing in front of the vehicle on the left side, because I'm not in reverse. I'm in just park. So when I go forward, I can kind of see, you know, what's in front of me when I'm driving slow. I think you can go up to 6 miles per hour while looking at these cameras. And on the right, this is really awesome. It looks like it has a camera underneath both rear view mirrors, front and back. So it gives you literally an around view of the car. And it kind of looks like there's a camera about 50 feet above you looking straight down. And you can see the camp that flag is waving there to the right, and you can see the shadows around the vehicle. And you can see they don't exactly line up perfectly, but it gives you a really good representation of where you're at. So when you put it in reverse, I'm going to put it in reverse now, it just changes to the rear screen. So now we're on the back, backup mode there. But you still have that around view on the right. Now, if I push, I'm going to go and put it back in park. Now I'm going to push the camera button again, and now it's going to focus. It's still aiming to the front, but now it's going to focus the right view here on the front right tire, the passenger side. So basically, right now, I'm going to turn the wheel just so you can see what I'm talking about. You see that wheel popping out there? So you can get right up on the curb, I mean, or you can parallel park like a boss with that camera. That is a really awesome feature because that's kind of like you really can't really tell from sitting in the driver's side how close you are to things. So this gives you can literally be right to the inch of something and know that you're not going to hit it. Very, very handy. Of course, you can always push this again and go back to the round view, which is a little bit less precise on the corners. That's why it has the sonar system. But it really gives you a good way to navigate through a parking lot without messing up your awesome new car. All right, so that's the kind of the basics. There's a lot of stuff going on with this screen. Of course, you've got satellite radio and navigation, and then different things like that. Let me go ahead and get rid of that and go back here. But anyways, lots of cool stuff there. Now, and then you've got the buttons that control that. This is where your CD player, this will also, CD player will also play DVDs, and that's where you play the DVDs in the back. And you got the AM/FM satellite radio. You can once you put a like a CD or whatever in there, then it'll pop up the information to change through the tracks and everything. But the basic controls there, you can tune through it, volumes right there, as well as on the steering wheel. Now below here is your climate control. We do have air conditioning, the defroster in the front and then the back. And basically mode changes. I'm gonna push mode to show you. It pops up on the screen. It changes where you want the air to blow. And then, of course, your temperatures pop up there. When I change the knob there, I can turn it. It kind of gives me different options there. So, and then your fan speed is here, temperature on the right and left. You can, right now it's on dual. I can always turn dual off to where they're synced, both same temperature on both sides. All right, there's two power supplies back in there. They're kind of hard to see because they're black and they kind of blend in, but here they are. Maybe you can see them better that way. Pretty good, nice pocket here. And so moving on here to the center console, let me get my phone out. Here's my phone, it's the Note 4. And basically I'm gonna go ahead and put it in here and see if it fits. And it fits perfectly. So there's one place to put my phone. And I know this is a large phone, so it's not gonna fit in the cup holders, which is a little bit disappointing. And it could be, the case on it, but of course you have to have a case on your phone pretty much. But so that's pretty much where I gotta put the phone is in there. So I guess that's how that rolls on this car. I guess I could put it in here. Let's see if it'll fit in this center console. And it does. So I can, run a wire out there and plug it in and charge it. So I guess I can put it in there too. This is your center console. It has two portions, this small portion there. And to tell you which side is which, it has these two buttons. You notice one has a texture on it. That's for the big butt pocket. And then there we got this little one here with no texture.
I mean, they're both the same size, so I guess the texture kind of helps out there. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the big pocket with the textured button. And this is where you'll find a power supply as well as a USB input and some RCA inputs there. And then a junk drawer to put stuff. Now, I guess if you put stuff in there, it's going to kind of, it might, you know, fill up and cover up those controls there. So you would definitely want to keep this power supply lid closed so stuff doesn't like get in there and short it out, especially pennies, or I think it's dimes or something like that, it'll do that. Alright, so here's the rearview mirror. It does have your HomeLink buttons here for your garage door controls, as well as on and off for your auto dim rearview mirror. There's a place to put some sunglasses. There's a light there, little LED lights for interior lights. So I'm going to show you something cool. I'm going to lean my chair back so we can kind of maybe get a better look here. Because this one has the sunroof here as well as one back there. So I'm going to start with the one back there, and there's a button here. So I'm gonna open that up. And that way you can, you know, feel less claustrophobic in the back. And then this button here opens up. This is actual sunroof here that you can open up and close it. You can also vent it. But the shade is manual, which of course this one back there, you can't really reach it, so I guess it's got the button there for the shade. So I'm going to go ahead and close it. I apologize for moving the camera around so much. It's kind of awkward position here to show you the ceiling. Alright, so the visors. It's a neat little place to put like your registration or your driver's license up here. There's a light mirror. Same thing on that side. Alright. I skipped over something. This right here is your four-wheel drive knob. And basically this one has a four-wheel drive. Basically you can just put it in two-wheel drive. Or you can switch it to auto like that. Or you can put it to four-wheel drive lock, and that'll lock it in four-wheel drive, like non-stop four-wheel drive. So you know, auto is more passive. You basically can put it in auto and the computer's pretty smart, and it kind of knows when you need four-wheel drive and not, so it can engage and disengage as it needs to without using too much, you know, not overdoing it. And of course you can stay in two-wheel drive if you want. Now this button right here is your downhill descent button. This is for off-road use only. So when you're going down a hill that's kind of slippery surfaces or loose rocks or gravel or something like that, and it's pretty steep, you can go ahead and push that, and it'll take you down that hill at a slow speed, at a more safely. I'm sure it's not going to, like, you know, keep you from sliding down like a slick ice or anything like that, but it, you know, does, you kind of have to try it out. I'm not really sure how to explain it. Maybe there's a video somewhere of somebody trying that out. If there is, and you know of it, please share it in the comments. It's always good to see, better than just hear about it. Alright, so let's look under the hood and see that 3.5 liter. V6. Now this one does have the 3.5 liter V6 with the VVT system. It's a little bit more advanced, and I can't remember the exact name, but I'll look at the window sticker and show you. And it also has a continuously variable transmission. CVT is what they're commonly known as. And so it keeps you at the right gear ratio so you can stay within the engine's power band. And if you're not really sure what that is, check out my video series called Ask the Engineer Student. He goes through and explains what the power band is and what gear ratios are and all that good stuff. So under here, you can actually see some engine here. It's the 3.5 liter V6, which Nissan puts in a lot of stuff. And you see everything is secure, all the cables are secure. There's nothing loose and very, very tidy under the hood. And you got some noise dampeners and stuff like that around the hood and also underneath here. All right, let me show you on the window sticker something that I cannot remember. Continuous Valve Timing Control System, CVTCS. So I'm not an expert on that, so if you know anything about that, share it in the comments or share a video explaining that, what the difference between that and just VVT. Continuous Valve Timing Control System. I don't know if that's any different from VVT or not, just let me know. But it does have the Xtronic CVT continuously variable transmission, and that basically, like I said, it has more than just a few gears. I mean, it doesn't really have specific gears. It has the ability to change the gear ratio on the fly. So anyway, if you have any questions, have anything to add, if there's anything that I skipped over or got wrong, please correct me in the comments. And if there's anything I can do to improve my videos, just let me know in the comments as well. Grand Strand Nissan. It's a really, really awesome dealership. If you ever come to Myrtle Beach on vacation, or if you're in the Myrtle Beach area, definitely check them out. If you're on vacation, you can stop by here. You can get yourself a vehicle and upgrade and drive home in a new vehicle. And I'm sure they'll pick you up at the airport too if you'd like to do that. So anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.